In this video, I'm going to talk to you about Trilofan, which is also called profenazine, which can be very effective for psychosis, but it's not often used nowadays. I'm Dr. Anthony Collada. I'm a board certified psychiatrist. Trilofan is known as a first generation antipsychotic. First generation meaning it's basically one of the first antipsychotics that was available, and it's thought to work by blocking the dopamine D2 receptors. And so we don't exactly know how this medication works, but it's one of the reasons why we think schizophrenia and psychosis has to do with too much dopamine in parts of the brain, because this medication is thought to decrease the dopamine levels, which thereby decreases the psychotic symptoms that people who are suffering from conditions such as schizophrenia may present with. But the reason this medication is not used much nowadays is due to the side effect profile. And the side effects in particular include the Parkinson-like symptoms that can come with this medication. Dopamine works in a few ways in the brain. It works in the mesolimbic pathway, which is like the emotional center of the brain. It works in the mesocortical pathway, or more like the thinking and planning part of the brain. And there's also the nigrostriatal pathway. And that basically deals with a lot of movements. And so when you block the dopamine pathway that leads to movements, it's gonna more likely lead to blockage of these things, which is what happens in Parkinson's disease. In Parkinson's disease, there's less dopamine in the brain, and so it leads to the symptoms that people with Parkinson's get. They get shaking, they maybe walk with a shuffling gait, maybe they have a stooped posture. These are all signs of Parkinson's disease, and these are also signs that people can get, or side effects people can get from this medication when they take it for several years. So if there's just one psychotic break someone is suffering with, or they don't have a long condition of psychosis or schizophrenia, then maybe they won't ever develop the symptoms such as Parkinson's. But for people who do need to take this medication for the majority of life or for the rest of their life, it can very well lead to some of these Parkinson-like features, which is one of the reasons this medication is not used much nowadays. Another reason can be the cardiac effects, meaning it can affect the heart, in particular the electrical activity of the heart, leading more likely that people suffer from conditions like heart attacks and things like that. This is more common in people who are older or who have a history of heart problems or conditions, but theoretically it can happen to just about anybody. Now, typically the dosing of this medication start as small as 2 or 4 milligrams a day, divided up to 3 or 4 times a day. And the maximum dose, according to what I've seen through this app called Hippocrates, is 64 milligrams a day. Typically people that are older can have their symptoms controlled on smaller doses, whereas people who have stronger or higher psychotic symptoms probably need higher doses to help address it. One of the good things about this medication is it's not typically associated with weight gain or high cholesterol or increased risk of diabetes as much as the newer antipsychotic drugs are. So if someone is afraid of weight gain or those things, this could be an option for you. However, it is most notably known for the side effects of the Parkinson's-like or the shaking that can happen, also the cardiac effects. So those are some things to definitely monitor. Look, medications are not necessarily the only solution for schizophrenia or psychotic symptoms. A lot of times schizophrenia or psychosis can be triggered from a lot of stress or emotional instability, from not sleeping, from drugs such as methamphetamines, cannabis. So you gotta make sure you handle the stress right. You gotta make sure to minimize, if not stop altogether, the drugs. Oftentimes schizophrenia has something in one's life or one's environment that has triggered the psychotic episode. So there could be a genetic predisposition to it. Also, the stress can just kind of be a lot. And so the combination of factors can lead on to having a psychotic episode. If you've had just one psychotic episode, you may not need to be on the medications for the rest of your life. You could talk with your doctor about potentially tapering off the medication if you feel like the side effects are not really worth it. The more psychotic episodes or psychotic breaks one has had in their life, the more likely they're gonna get psychotic episodes down the road. So you gotta really gauge, is it the benefits versus risks? A lot of times people with schizophrenia unfortunately do not wanna take medications. They don't think they're sick, they don't think they have a problem. And so that can be really challenging for the providers, it can be challenging for their family or their friends and their loved ones who to try to help support them through the disease. So those are just some thoughts about Trilofan. Typically, I don't see it much these days anymore. I do have maybe just a handful, if not even that much, many patients in my private practice that see it. In the hospital, I don't really see it that much anymore, just because there's other medications that are newer, that are more commonly prescribed. And so due to the potential risk of the Parkinson's-like features or cardiac effects, people don't often take this. Some other side effects, which are rare but can happen with this antipsychotic as well as any, is this condition called NMS, or neuroleptic malignant syndrome, where people can get very high fevers, blood pressure fluctuates, they could start breathing fast or rapidly. Basically, it's a severe condition. Oftentimes, they need to stop the antipsychotics, get admitted to the hospital, make sure they get adequate hydration and something to calm themselves, calm down their muscles. Because of this autonomic instability that the body goes through. It's very rare, doesn't happen often, but it is something to be cautious or be aware of about.